keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine. I walk the line.
Hey y'all, welcome back to Homestead, and today is going to be full of trying to teach y'all and learn ourselves and try to get everything done. This is Fencing for Dummies, and if y'all didn't know, we are the dummies. This is our first time starting fencing. Well, technically yesterday was our first time starting fencing. I'm going to try and explain how we did it and how we got it tight, but that is just going to be the dummy part of me trying to explain to y'all. And everything doesn't really come out the way I want it to, so we're going to get through this together. Just my mom and I got this fencing done, just so y'all know how easy it is. Fencing for dummies. It only took us 2 hours to get it.
It's time consuming and it hurts your hands, but
it's fun.
It's fun. It's a project outside. It's beautiful weather right now. And, you know, we're getting ready before the next spring, so we won't have time. We're running out of time between now and winter time, but
it's just already getting in the 60s, so
yeah,
we're enjoying it.
And it was high of 53 yesterday, so yeah, we're running out of time, so we have to get this done, and we're just going to bring y'all along for our project.
And maybe try and get y'all to do a project that y'all are holding off on.
Yeah, everybody should be preparing something right now. Every day, y'all should be doing something to move forward to be a little more self-sustainable right now in the times that we're living in. So right now, this is our project, getting ready for sheep and chickens and everything else. So hopefully we can help motivate everybody to...
You stepped in it, didn't you?
No, to move forward. I did not.
Anyway, I'm going to put y'all on a time lapse. I might stop the time lapse to show y'all how we're doing it. But I'm still learning how to film. I'm still learning the ins and outs of all of this. So we're learning together. We're growing together. And that's just how the homestead works, is not everything goes as planned. So you just work around it and you learn.
And there's no way that you could possibly know everything there is to know about a homestead, because everybody, every day is learning something new anyway. So,
all right.
This is just our challenge for this week.
Let's get this done.
Let's go.
I will see y'all when I get to figuring out how I'm going to show y'all this process. So anyway, I'm going to put on a time lapse and let's go. Okay, while she's over there clearing out the rest of the fence line that we didn't get to on the mower with the weed eater, I'm going to be showing y'all how we tightened up the fence. But before the anchoring point, what we did is we rolled the entire roll of fencing out. We just rolled it all the way down from all the way down there, and we just unrolled it all the way down here. That makes life a lot easier when dealing with like 500 pounds of fencing. So after we rolled it out, we anchored it to the fence. Of course, there's going to have to be somebody holding it up while somebody's anchoring it, just to make sure that everything's lined up properly. If you don't have anybody to hold it up for you, I would recommend doing what we did here, is we took the top square and we folded it over a T-post that's a distance away. So what we did to tighten it up is we took a 2x4, a regular just 2x4 board, and we weaved it in between the 4x4 squares. And then while the fencing is still laying down, we put toe straps around both ends of the 2x4. So you have to make sure the 2x4 is pretty long enough to get through both sides. So we took a towing strap and we put it on both sides of the fencing. Now, we used our truck for this, but when it gets to a little bit of a needier spot, we're going to use the mower for that. But we used the truck, we hooked up the both towing straps to the front end of the truck, and we backed up until the fencing was tight. Yes, it will pull. So if your anchor point is strong enough, it will pull and it'll probably stand it up depending on how you anchor it. But if it doesn't stand up, just do the anchor point that I showed you here, a distance away from where you're working. So after that, you're gonna have someone push up against the fence. I recommend starting from the bottom up, from going work your way up from the T-post. So you're going to have someone pushing on the fence so it lines up, make sure it's hitting the ground the way you want it, make sure it's lined up the way you want it. You're going to have someone hooking, but with those eye hooks I showed you, you're going to have someone be setting those up. By the time you get two done, I'm sure you can work on your own T-post. So it's really just a two-person job, unless you want to get it done fast and you have like six people working on it. all in all, it really is easy to do. Just my mom and I, we've been out here doing this fencing for 2 hours, and we got this entire row done for 2 hours. That is not bad, but we were also learning in the process, so we did take a little bit of dummy time with it as well. But I hope this explains a lot to y'all. It helps a lot when you have a T-post and something that's strong enough to pull the fencing tight. But other than that, I'm going to go ahead and put you on a little time lapse so we can get this whole row done and get the next adventure started. So here's the system we have going on right now is we aren't using the same size for this scenario. We would use the bigger 2x4 for this, but she has to be on the other side of the road in the ditch area. Reason why is that property is not ours. Our property goes back that way. If we knew our neighbors, they would probably let us on that, but we haven't met them yet and they haven't introduced themselves yet. So pretty much here on the homestead, you really got to deal with what life throws at you. So this is our current setup right now, but anyway, we're going to go ahead and we're going to get this done and maybe we can finish this fence line today. Okay, so we finally got the row done. What we did is we cut all of the horizontal lines, like all of these. We cut those out to where it was just the strip of wire. And whenever we had the strip of wire, we took it and we wrapped it around here. So you can tell like this spot is a little bit wider than this spot right here. That's because it's cut out and it was wrapped around itself. She is going to go continue weed eating, y'all know what I mean, the fence line, and we're going to go get that cleared out. But we got the side done. We did it. So my camera died right there, so the quality is bad. I'm sorry. The reason why I don't post is mainly because I don't want to have to stress about camera battery, and I don't know what y'all want to see, so if y'all would put that in the comments on what content y'all would like to see, it'd be great. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and cut the video off here. We're going to continue working. And if y'all have a project y'all need to get done, go ahead and get it done. It's never too late and it's never too early to start. I'm going to probably go get something to eat real quick and come back out. But anyway, have a great day. Welcome back to Homestead. And enjoy y'all's crazy lifestyle because no one else gets to enjoy a life that they create for themselves. Anyway, have a great day. I'm going to go ahead and work.